Prepare to fight.
Yeah, we are. The players are getting ready. But while we're going here, let's just give a big shout out to Steel Series. They hooked us up with some gear to help us, kind of bring you the coverage here. Game Rail, we haven't really talked about them very much, but
and we also want to talk to that real quick. Oh, just
too
a little late.
We're going live here.
Esports Magazine,
match,
check that out. Make sure you've heard about that. And we're going to go right into the matches. The two teams have lived up. We have got MYM on the offensive side, Fnatic on the defensive side. What do you think is going to happen here in this pistol round?
Well, Fnatic has consistently lost pistol rounds throughout this tournament. So I think MYM has a good chance to get out here early and maybe take it to Fnatic. Let's see what will happen. But again, Fnatic has, on the other hand, come back and won the second round after losing the pistol several times. It'll be interesting to see. Well, I bet Fnatic will purchase Deagles if they lose this round. So let's take a look. Element is the guy on your screen. Bomb right now in the hands of Real, who's behind him. It's going to be a rush inside. Take a look and see what happens. Force consistently starting things off here. Fnatic is going to go to work with three big frags on the entry.
Yeah, so this really shut down that rush. They're going to get a plan here, though. But Force is going to go finish him off. Now he's going to go looking for some more as his teammates come to help defuse.
There's Karn.
And Karn finishing it up for him. So nice job.
So Fnatic actually gets the pistol there, but the important plant for MYM, three big frags for Force there in that round, but that plant could enable them to buy early.
Yeah, so MYM will look to see if they can buy, and we get an instant replay right off the bat here as they came down the low ramp, tried to get the plant, they did, and Force came in, taking that out, and was able to help win that round for his team with, like you said, three big frags. And again, Force setting the tempo early. We talked about how he's the key player for Fnatic, their top fragger. Well, he's off to a good start, and that spells real good news for the Fnatic members.
Looks like it's going to be a simple outside rush for MYM, and Fnatic's not even going to allow a frag here for MYM. How important is that?
If we have the rules for Counter-Strike, let's go over those real quick. I know there's a lot of people who have never seen Counter-Strike before that may be watching us here in the finals. Again, 5-on-5 play. Both teams have five players, similar to the NBA basketball. Again, none of the players can see each other. They don't know where each other is at on the map. It's not like basketball where you can see the opposing team. The idea is you have to communicate with your teammates, tell each other where they're at, visual, audio cues, let each other know, and then try to predict the other team's movements, react to their strategies. Again, like you said, early plant here by MYM in the first round is now allowing them to come back here in the second round or in this third round and buy early. They've got the AKs, the assault rifles, and that the cost of that has been helped out by the fact that they did plant that bomb, that extra $800.
You know, I'm taking a look here at the defensive setup. Looking for us, two big frags, headshots, both of them. So he's really set the pace inside, shutting that bomb site down. Looks like Zion's the only one he's with the bomb, and Element's on the other side of the map. So
he's
right
going to flank a guy right here.
Let's see what happens here outside.
You can see Zion.
Dropping around. That's Element by the 5 train on the
outside.
Yeah,
I'm sorry. Element flanking right there. Able to get one, and that really turned this round as Zion's going to pick up another, and it's going to put DSN in a 2-on-1.
Yeah, this was a 3-on-2 situation for Fnatic, and they just blew that round. And finally, the Terrorists are going to pick it up here, 2-1. Element, a big-time flank over by the alleyway, really turned that round around for those guys.
Yeah, interesting play right there. MYM trying to go into the inner bomb site again, and Forrest steps up, takes out two guys, and really shuts that down. I don't know what the plan was there. It sounded like maybe it was a fake for MYM, but Forrest destroyed that because Element, their key player, was on the other side of the map at the alley. So for some reason, they were able to rotate in and go back. Forrest really destroyed that round, but I don't really know what the original plan was for MYM because that was a really spread out strat by them. They're lucky to pull that round out.
Fnatic is going to be forced to save after losing that third round there, so they will have just USPs. You can see MYM smartly holding back all of them inside those halls right now. We call them the White Halls there. And you can see on the overhead, just kind of all clustered together, an AWP up there on the ledge. You can see that. Looks like MYM's going to try and work inside, and it would be a smart play right now.
DSN is right behind that box out in front of him, so he may get a couple here. We'll see what happens.
Let's see if MYM is smart enough to check the spots, and they are PRB. We saw some sloppy play early in the tournament, teams not checking spots, but it looks like a big TK there is going to seriously hurt the money situation inside for Fnatic.
That That's another error by Fnatic. They had a guy crater early on in one of the early rounds, one of the save rounds, and now they've got a TK here. So Fnatic has already made two mistakes in this map. That hurts especially because that's you lose $3,300 for TKing a teammate. So there's this money system going on in the background here. You get $3,200 for winning, or $3,500, excuse me, for winning roughly, and you get $1,400 for losing. So if you kill your own teammate, you lose $3,300. That's a big chunk of change, especially when you consider the fact that you got to buy guns. The AK is worth $2,500 and the M4 is worth $3,200. So those weapons make it very difficult to have weapons and be able to successfully defend or attack if you're doing things like TKing your teammates or losing rounds consistently.
Yeah, so let's take a look at Fnatic here. They will be saving yet again. Remember, they won the first two rounds, but they've lost the last two. So score tied 2-2, you can see on the scoreboard there. And right now, again, this is a good save strategy for MYM. I like how they hold back. They are not going to allow anyone to rush. They are going to drop down the ladder, but you can see Karn is going to be waiting for them here. It's going to be tough to get a frag with that USP, as you can see. MYM going to work back inside. Smart kind of hiding from that right now, and they're going to get the first frag there as they make their way in. That's Element starting things off.
Yeah, save round right here, and Fnatic reacting to this lower push by MYM. It looks like they're going to get in here and get a plant on this save round. Archie, they're hiding, hoping somebody will push up. Oh. But you know what? Grain's going to welcome him to the match. And it looks like the guys here for MYM are going to clean this up.
Nice
3-2 shot. 3-2 score now in favor of MYM as they come back. That early buy has paid off well. Like we talked about, they got the plant in the first round, so it wasn't a total loss. They came back in the third round and bought, and now they've won three straight as they take the lead from Fnatic. And the game is starting to turn here on Fnatic. They need to start getting, I believe, an op in the hands of DSN. We've seen him earlier in this tournament absolutely become a human highlight reel on train with that AWP, so they need to get him one soon.
You know, DSN is used to playing inside. Right now, Tentpole is the guy inside for Fnatic. Some spam. Karn looks like he came through below the ladder. Some action there. He gets three big frags. You can see DSN, and right now Fnatic has a nice strong round so far. Element, the last member alive. The smart thing would be to save here, but I think Tentpole is going to come up on him right here. Let's see what happens. Tentpole gets the best of him with a quick headshot. No match for that.
And I don't know if we saw that on the screen, but DSN killing Element there up. Killing him up above the ladder. But he picked up the AWP, and Temple did. He's going to give it to DSN, and that's going to allow DSN to get an AWP like we talked about. So that was, something you may not have seen, but that's a little play inside the game that's going to be important, because as soon as DSN gets that AWP, he's going to be able to really step it up. And we're already seeing him set up in the lower bomb site all by himself. So that AWP he picked up could be huge here.
Yeah, let's see. It looks like MYM's going to go inside here. They do have guns. Those AK-47s are going to make their way up. DSN, the sole member inside, joined now by Karn. You can see him back there with that big AWP. He's been very successful with it. Whiffs on a shot right there. And Zion is going to get a kill inside. We should have a successful plant. There it is. He puts it down. Another missed shot there. So DSN not looking so hot today with that AWP.
He's not on, and that's not good for Fnatic. They had Forrest playing well, but they need DSN helping out if they're going to win this.
Oh,
there's
one,
though.
Lands that nice shot down long. Archie's going to come in, though, on the flank. He's coming from inside. You can see DSN finally doing some work for Fnatic. They're going to get on the bomb. It's a two-on-one situation.
Forrest PRB is covering him here.
PRB's up high. PRB takes the guy down, and let's see what happens
DSN
here.
But DSN got the defuse. Yeah,
the defuse in time. Good cover there. You can see that solid play by the guy behind him. That was Forrest. On the instant replay here, DSN, let's take a look at the shots here. But solid cover there is nice. Really what made that round happen by Forrest. We've seen some sloppy cover this tournament, too.
Yeah, we've seen a lot of guys giving up, not protecting the guy that's defusing. And in that situation, Forrest gave up himself to allow DSN to get that defuse. Forrest was underneath the train, came out, made a nice distracting movement, and PRB came out, only saw Forrest, took him out, and then hid. And all that while DSN was defusing, able to get that bomb defused and win the round. So Fnatic retaking the lead 4-3 here as we start to move into this eighth round. Action already underway.
Yeah, MYM is going to be allowed to buy here because of that plant. That plant gave them some extra money even though they lost the round. MYM going to make their way into that lower bomb site here. DSN and Karn, though, are both there. They're going to take one of those guys out. Looks like Juvie was there. Karn up top, you can see him on your screen right now, has the Colt. and the bomb is going to be planted. It's now a 3-on-2. DSN has to rotate from outside. Real is on the ground. PRB up high, exchanging fire with Karn. He has just 36 health now. They need to get in. It's going to be tough, though, with the positioning of MYM. I think I'm going to give them the edge on this round.
They definitely do, and Real is hiding here. He might get DSN. I think the call has come out to save the weapons. DSN and Karn both falling back right now, and Real is on the hunt. Well, he slowed down, so it looks like they're both going to get to save out their weapons. We might see a battle here. Karn is going to get snuck up on by Real here.
And he has low health, so I think he hears him coming. Going to hide out here, and Real gets the best of him. The low health is the reason there that he went down. Not going to be able to save that M4.
The key, though, DSN did stay alive. He still got that AWP. Again, the AWP is a big weapon. It's a one-shot, one-kill weapon, so it's a very important weapon to have. You normally have one guy who's in charge of playing that position, whether it be like Fraud for Complexity or, you know, for example, DSN for Fnatic. Every team seems to have one good AWP, and if you don't, you have to change your strategies accordingly in order to make up for that. So, again, keeping that AWP for DSN is a big deal right now.
You can see Fnatic has pushed up inside here. If we can take a look possibly at the overhead. Force, there he is. He's right in front of Element here. You can see Element knows he's coming. A nice grenade. Force is going to retreat back down, but he runs up, gets the frag, and falls back.
The nice combination here. Fnatic has DSN with that AWP playing back. Force being aggressive right there. So that inner bomb site, they're playing very well with it. But I'm surprised. MYM seems to want to challenge that.
Oh,
I don't know why.
Nice shot by DSN there.
Nice, yeah. I just don't see why MYM continues to press the action there. They should be trying to hit, maybe split the outside bomb site more, and it's causing some issues here because they're running right into DSN, who's starting to get hot here. That AWP is starting to hit, and they need to go somewhere else if they're going to want to be successful.
And Karn has done a nice job of shutting down the ladder area. It seems like MYM doesn't want to attack the outside, possibly because they saw how well Fnatic played it yesterday on this map. It's such a solid map. It's their choice. We talked about how important it is to win your own map, and I think Fnatic really has the edge on this one. They played so well on train at this tournament. It's going to be so difficult to beat them on it. You see a missed shot there by DSN, but the plant is going to go down. No, it's not. It looks like Forrest and
nice.
Karn come together. Perfect timing. Denies the plant. Denies the 500 bucks you get piece. And nice, smart play by Fnatic.
We talked about this too. DSN and Forrest playing with each other. They knew DSN was AWPing. They can hear that AWP blasting away from across the map. So what does Forrest do? He knows they've got to hide from it. So he sneaks his way up the side there, up that high ramp at the bottom of the screen like he's doing right now, and takes out the guy planting the bomb. Excellent awareness by Forrest. That's why he's the best player on this team. That's why he's so amazing. DSN's hitting some amazing shots, but if you're watching this game, Forrest is really the one doing a lot of damage. Temple pushing up right there, takes out one guy. There's actually two of them there. See it. We've got a split rush from MYM right now.
It looks like this was a 2-1-2. Two to the ladder, one middle, two to the alleyway, and the guys in the ladder area got shut down by Fnatic outside. You can see right now this is PRB falling back. The bomb is dropped inside of the ladder area, and that was done on purpose by Zion. He didn't want to get out there. Karn takes him out, though. You can see PRB is stuck now in a 2-on-1. Forrest is going to go inside and maybe try and get the flank here, and Karn is there in the middle to take PRB out. Not expecting it.
Can we go to the Telestrator real quick? I wanted to show something really fast to what happened there in that round. We see a lot of action. That defensive spawns a large area. So what you have is they can spawn anywhere in here. And if they rush really fast, they can get out. So what happened is the guys for Fnatic got out here to the electrical box. And when the guys for the offense got out here, they were already waiting for them, able to take them out and have that crossfire. So great job using your spawns by the Fnatic team. So great job and a save round here by MYM coming up.
Going to be a rush inside for MYM. You see PRB on your screen. Forrest gets three big frags. Karn finishes off. Nice, easy save for those guys. It was a rush for MYM. I think they just wanted to get that one over with. 7-4 is the score. Fnatic up on the CT side, but this is a CT-sided map. You would expect this.
Well, again, you spoke to it. 15 rounds on offense, 15 rounds in defense. I sound like a broken record, but a lot of people may not hear this or may not know it. You get 15 rounds on each side, then you switch. So now the first team to 16 is going to win this. We've got three more rounds left in this half. Again, if you're Fnatic, you're feeling very good on this side. You've already got 7. That means you need to get a few more here. And if you get to maybe, say, 11, all you need to do is get 5 in the second half. Force going nuts in the lower bomb site right now. And then Karn's going to say, well, I need a few frags, and nades him. And so now let's see what they can do here in this lower bomb site to stop this rush.
Right now it's a 3-on-2, so we still have a couple guys left alive for Fnatic. 2 for MYM, Meet Your Maker, Element being one of them. Remember, they won a 2-on-3 earlier in this map, but right now they're stuck inside, and it looks like they're going to split up. PRB is here just below the ladder. That's the ladder is right behind him and to the left. And Element does have the bomb. So MYM, if they play this right, could possibly get in here. It's going to be hard going outside, though, against these guys who are going to have a lot of places to hide.
Let's show an overhead real quick of how this round is developing really quick. You can see the two players moving around. Two players there in the back. So Element and BRB have an opportunity here to get a plant if they can get in there. There it goes.
Let's see, and I think DSN's going to try and come up on Element here. Is he going to get the bomb down? He does indeed. Let's see what happens. Jumps over to fire there. Has a grenade out still. He's now under five, but a nice shot from Archie will take him out, making it a 3-on-1. But all PRB has to do is to defend the bomb here. It is planted. The time is ticking. 35 seconds total for that. Makes it a 2-on-1. Tentpole drops him, and they will get the defuse here.
That's all about teamwork. Again, we said they can't see each other, so what the team has to do is tell each other where the guys are at. Fnatic, excellent job communicating right there, telling him that they were at the end of that, telling him that each other that he was at the end of the train there. They both able to lock in on him, and he had nowhere to go. He was totally pinned, so one of the guys could have gone after him, taking him out. The other guy could have gone and defused, so he really had to press the action there. That played into their hands. They were able to both fire at him, take him out, and defuse and win that round. Again, Fnatic going up 8-4 score. Some good teamwork here early on by this team. And again, this is a very defensive favored map, so I expect Fnatic to play well in this half.
But if we could see maybe two more rounds for the terrorists here, the offensive side, MYM, I think that would put them in a pretty decent position in the second half, at least a winnable situation here. So we have a rush down the alley. Looks like outside there was one guy in the middle as well, but Forrest took care of that. Right now, Fnatic just going to work on these guys, mowing them down. There's just one left alive. I believe that is real, and he goes down. He had the bomb there. No chance. Just one member of Fnatic. The only one to go down there for the CTs, and another round, 9-4. I think in this position, MYM needs to win out to have a chance.
Exactly right, I agree. They need to win this last two rounds to give themselves a nice opportunity in the second half. But if you're Fnatic, try to get yourself another round here. Try to get to 10-5, maybe even 11-4, and you look absolutely smart in going into the second half. You'll be in a great position. You could just win 4 or 5 rounds, maybe as many as 6 at most, and now you're in a position where you can just totally steamroll MYM going into their map.
Looks like MYM's going to work inside, but Forrest has just been stellar in there. Look at him just going to work, mowing him down with the help of DSN, that AWP in the back of the site. A nice, quick, easy round. I think that was a deep save. Yeah, he did. I mean, he was right there looking for the frag and the money. 10-4 is the score. We're heading into the last round here. Not looking so good right now for MYM on this first map.
Yeah, MYM taking an opportunity to save this round and try to go after it. Again, here's a new replay of it. Nice little turns around the corner. He found 3 guys there. DSN's going to take that last one, but Forrest, he won't care. He got quite a bit this map already. He's got 19 frags, 19-6 for Forrest. Unbelievable play for him. MYM, again, saved this last round in order to get themselves an opportunity to buy this round, so it's going to be important for them to pick up this round and try to build some momentum going into the second half.
A little bit of a change here. DSN, you saw him spotted by MYM, was the only member of Fnatic inside, and he's going to pay for it. He gets picked. He had pushed up that AWP and tried to get a pick, missed his shot. Now MYM is going to make their way into the site, but it looks like it could have been a fake here, some kind of diversion. The bomb right now is outside. You can see it here in the hands of Zion. He's going to make his way around. He's at the 5 train now. Picks the guy off in middle. What a shot. Just coming around. He's going to get the plant outside. A nice little fake inside.
Nice,
but look at Fnatic's retake of the bomb site.
Yeah, Karn came all the way around from the flank there and took out the planter as he was trying to plant. Forrest also doing some damage there as MYM tried to push on him. He took out a few of them. That was a mistake. They shouldn't have gone there. Should have held down that bomb site. Somebody should have been watching the flank for the planter. They weren't. Instead, they were pressing on Forrest. So, again, trying to push that middle Z-Hall there instead of helping out and defending the guy planting the bomb. Big mistake.
Karn over by the power box was there. Nice positioning by Karn. He's had a really good tournament so far. All these guys have. And it's going to be an 11-4 first half score. Going to be so difficult to come back on this map. We saw Fnatic play this thing so offensively yet the last 2 days. And they just are a powerhouse on offense, which is something that's not doesn't happen too often.
Yeah, I really feel like in that first half, we saw MYM press a lot more than they needed to. Example, that last round as they went aggressive there. Looking at the overhead again, we saw they really tried to press here into the middle as they came in. Let's go to the stats. That's a great opportunity here. See the first half stats here, thanks to GameSense. Some good information right there. 20-6 for Forrest is absolutely dominating. A 120 DAR. Look at Karn, though. Amazing DAR there, 130. Again, every shot you do does damage to the opposing team. our game sense statistics track that damage, so you can see damage doesn't always result in frags. You can spam through a wall, you can shoot somebody, it may not hurt, it may not actually frag them or kill them, but it does give you some damage on them, and we track that data for you. Some assist totals there as well are an important stat to keep track of, as any assist, you do most of the damage, 50% of it, and your teammate picks up a frag, that's one assist for you. So good job with those statistics right there during the middle of the match, and we're going in as Forrest pushes into the bomb site here as Fnatic tries to get a plan.
We are on the T pistol, the offensive pistol for Fnatic here. Looks like Element and Juvie there got a couple of frags, but now Fnatic is returning fire. The bomb is in there. It was dropped. They're going to pick it up. Karn has it, but you can see Forrest is really going on the hunt. He's heading towards the back, a place where a lot of the CTs like to hide. Bomb planted, so some money for those guys if they do lose this round. It's a 2-on-2. Karn inside up high.
There's a guy above him right here. Sorry,
here's Forrest.
Cut you off.
Here's Forrest. You see him coming up here. Comes from behind. He snuck around, gets the frag, makes it a 2-on-1. Juvie in a bad situation, and a beautiful USP shot from Forrest. Gets the guy as he's coming up the ladder. Nice shot.
Forrest has absolutely taken over this match. Him in the pink hat right there, that's Mr. Forrest, and he has just come to play is all I can say. Three more frags in this opening pistol. That's six frags in the two pistol rounds in this match. That's absolutely clutch.
Well, he's carrying his team in the pistol rounds right now, and you can see the shot right here. Boom, gets the guy. You know, that's one thing that was possibly could be the reason why Fnatic hadn't played so well on pistol rounds. I think maybe they heard what we were saying. They've won both of them so far in this map. Not something we've seen them consistently do throughout the tournament.
They need their big player to step up pistol rounds for them to win it. He's done it in both of these. Coming to play in the big match situation is Forrest.
Yeah, we can see a nice shot there from down long, but he gets picked off there by USP. A deagle frag, I'm sorry, for MYM. Some deegs, but only one frag there for MYM. Fnatic cleans up that save.
Yeah, so right now moving into this third round as the two teams setting up for what should be a gun round here. Again, MYM is going to have to save here on the defensive side. Those expensive $3,200 Colts are going to not allow them to buy. Again, another save. Should see the next round be a gun round. And a lot of pressure on MYM to come back in this match. I think they need to do it. A little bit of damage here, even if they don't win this half or map. They need to get a few rounds here to build for the next map, so they've got a lot of work ahead of them.
Oh, Element tries to sneak by Karn, but he doesn't. A Galil there in Karn's hands, just deadly with no armor there for those guys, so it looks like Fnatic is going to... They are in solid control of the outside. MYM had a four-man stack inside, looking for a rush, and Fnatic did a nice job of predicting down here. The bomb gets planted. Forrest and Archie, Tentpole, all adding frags there for those guys. So just another win. We're going to finally move into our first gun round of the second half. 3-0 the score here in that second half, and right now we're getting very, very close to game point.
I want to see more of an aggressive attack here on Fnatic. We saw them play offensive sides before. They were absolutely dominant. We saw them play their semifinal match against Pentagram, and they had 25 rounds on the two maps on the offensive side they won. So there was 30 rounds they played on offense. They won 25 of them, including a map on Train. So they were utterly dominant here on the offensive side. And you can tell they're on offense because at the top of the screen, they've got the red behind their name. That's the offensive side. The blue is behind MYM. They're on defense. So if you're quickly looking at the scoreboard trying to figure out who's on offense and who's on defense, that's available to you right there at the top of the screen.
Fnatic 14-4. They need just two more rounds to take this first map of in the best of three format here, but MYM is going to try and stay alive, getting the first two frags here, making it a 5-on-3. Looks like Fnatic's going to try and hit the outside again. Tentpole gets two frags, though, and he's going to make this interesting. It's now a 1-on-1. He has the bomb, and he's going to run back with it.
Can Forrest do it? He's only got 15 HP right now against Real. Real is still trying to figure out where he went. I would not have expected this if I was Real either, so Real is going to just have to hope he can outguess Forrest, and he might if he just stays right there. Forrest peeks out right now. It might be an interesting situation. Let's watch this develop.
Right, just 22 seconds left here in the round, so that is a time. Keep your eye on the timer.
Oh, I think he just walked right by him. They did. They walked right by him. He's right behind him there. Real's going to get him
there
right there.
There it is, MYM. So they stay alive here in the round. A little bit poor there for Forrest. He missed the guy high, right in the open there. Right in the open in the corner, just near the ladder. So 3-1 the score here. But that was critical. They needed to win that round to still, NYM did, to still have a shot at winning this first map.
Yeah, nice job, and he had to step up there, and Real was able to pull that off. Again, he was right there underneath the train. He should have seen him. We saw him on that screen. We can't believe Forrest didn't see him. He's been playing so well. That surprised me he didn't see him on the screen. And a little bit of a mistake there from that top player in that 1v1.
Yeah, here we go. We're going to have a Fnatic three-man rush outside. Through the alleyway with guns, it's a 1-1-3, split to the outside bomb site, and we got Zion just going to work. PRB adds with the Famous. Here's DSN on your main screen with 74 health. He does have the bomb there, so he's going to get that planted, going to give them some money. Forrest is here on the top of the ladder chain, but he gets taken out by PRB. It's now a 1-on-1. Let's take a look at PRB. He has that FAMAS. You can see him here heading down the train. He's going to run into DSN real quick here, Trev. And this is another critical round for these guys.
Yeah, this is absolutely critical.
Oh, DSN gets him with a headshot.
DSN picking up that round, winning it for his team. And that really puts a bad money situation for MYM. They bought that one round and they won. But again, they lose the next round. Now, the Counter-Strike allows you to come back. You get $1,400 if you lose. But you also get more and more money as you lose more and more consecutive rounds. That way, the game helps you try to get back into it if you are losing. Well, the problem is they are not going to get that because they won that round. So again, they lost 3-1-1, and now they've lost another. So that kind of clears that whole build-up for them, and now they're going to be forced to save here. But you know what? A nice deagle opening there for MYM as they start this off in their favor.
Yeah, but Fnatic needs just this round to win it. It's 15-5. We have the bomb dropped as the guy was trying to plant it inside, but here's Forrest. You can see him up top going to try and get some long-range frags here. He's out in the open. A nice pick there. Nice pick. I think that was Real who went down. You can see PRB and Juvie are still alive. Zion on the flank in a 3-on-2. Fnatic has just two guys left. They need to get that plant down. There's Zion from behind. He came from the ladder area. Forrest knows he's there, but he's got so many guys to worry about him that he's going to have no chance. Deagle down by PRD. That was a good Deagle save win there, but again, MYM trying to stay in this here.
The key right there is they got the guy as he was trying to plant the bomb. He went to plant the bomb. MYM pushed up, took him out, and nobody helping for Fnatic to cover him. Forrest was up top, wasn't able to get there, and a great job pushing up at the right time by the MYM defense, able to stop that plant, get themselves that round on a huge Deagle save. Maybe that'll turn momentum a little bit here, but again, still a long way left to go. Fnatic looks like they may be saving here in this situation. They are as a couple of guys going here to the alley.
Yeah, it's going to be a 3-2 split, looks like, to the outside. So the guys in the middle are the ones that have the bomb, but a huge nade from Zion takes a bunch of them out. They're going to clean him up. Karn, the only one managing to get a frag there. Element drops him with Colt Fire from the middle on the CT side. Another round win for MYM, but just a simple save there. And now we're going to see another gun round for Fnatic.
Yeah, again, Fnatic buying so many times in a row there, reached a point where they just didn't have enough after losing that Deagle save that MYM did against them. So they had to save there as well. So back-to-back save rounds, wins both by MYM, and they brought themselves back a little bit here. This is 15-7 overall, but still, again, like we said, only one more round Fnatic needs to win this.
Oh, man, Carton got dinked there as he tried to make his way in the site. A missed shot by Element. I mean, I wouldn't really call it maybe just a missed attempt at a frag there, and now Fnatic inside the lower bomb site. Again, Element not playing so well for his team. We talked about him being one of the key players. He has just two frags, seven deaths this half. He needs to step up and play big for his team in this next map because right now he's not doing it. You can see MYM is having a lot of trouble picking up rounds here in the second half.
Yeah, they are. And again, Fnatic starting to open it up here. Maybe they get a chance to pick this round up and finish off train.
A 2-on-1 here. Real needs to win it. He gets the first guy. If he wins this round, no. Tentpole is going to move Fnatic and give them the victory on this first map. We're going to move to the next one, which will be Mill.
Some early GGs there. That was still a close round. I'm surprised they were giving each other good games, even though it wasn't over. Forrest going to take a much-needed drink here as he did all the damage for his team in that first map. They're going to need more of the same from him in this next map if they hope to do well. Right back into the match as the two have lived up and ready to go. And Fnatic, MYM, on Mill. Let's get right to it.
MYM's going to take the CT side. They did pick this map. But if Fnatic can win this, they're going right home. They could sweep it right here by taking this map.
So watching as Fnatic sets up, they're going to rush here to the bottom of the screen, the far left. Maybe we can show it on overhead where they're going right now. There we go. We're looking as they move themselves to the bottom of the storage area number two. Storage area number one. Storage area number two is at the top. So here they go, boosted up the top. Take us away.
Hey, three guys in the middle there for MYM, but BSN is the first one to get the frag. A nice little midair Glock shot to the face by the guy from Fnatic, but now MYM Element is there with Real. They're taking back control. I think we do have a successful plant in the site.
No, it's not gone down. They trapped him on the right side here from your screen. Real. And finally, he got back over there. He was trapped on that right side and couldn't get over there. A mistake by Fnatic cost them a couple members, and now it looks like we're going to watch all that. You're going to fix it off, though.
Karn taking care of business right there with the USP that he picked up. A nice, solid play. Forced MYM into a two-on-one. That's not the situation they wanted to be in on the CT side.
If we do have the Telestrator, let's go to that real quick. We'll show what happened in that round. Again, the team coming up the middle here, and Fnatic came up the middle. Right up the middle here into bombsite A. One guy coming in from the flank. They were got a guy stuck over here on this side. He only could plant on this side of the map, though. So he had to jump across, and that kind of slowed down the attack there and really left the other team with an opportunity, but Fnatic able to close it off.
MYM is going to stack bombsite number one. That's the site that we just saw the action. And here's Element with a nice little boost. That's the great thing about this map for the defense, Trev. You can boost guys onto boxes all over the place and put them in defensive positions that make it difficult for an offensive attack into the bombsite. Fnatic spread things out just a little bit here. But now two guys from Fnatic going to make their way up. Boris is there. Gets two big ones. Real drops him. Karn is there with DSN, though, and a Deke shot to the face. That one hurt my head, man.
You saw DSN turn right there. He's trying to get out of the action. He knew he was under fire, but his teammate came up and pinned him. You hear a lot of those complaints on servers, but there's an actual opportunity in the situation where real professional players blocking each other off. You don't see that very often, and Fnatic blocking his teammate off, and he dies there. Two frags for MYM in that round, as right now we're watching as Real, the only one who's really stepped up so far, 4-2 score, excuse me, for MYM, Karn 5-0. So a 2-0 score for Fnatic as they move into the third round. Again, another save expected here from MYM as they're not able to buy those expensive M4s.
You know, I wouldn't be surprised to see Fnatic take this half of the map just because they're such an offensive powerhouse. They've been such of one the entire tournament long that I've just been completely impressed. We haven't seen that in such a long time, that offensive prowl. It's kind of like back a kickback to the days of Train with the old money system there. You used to see that all the time controlling it. So right now, score 2-0. DSN starts things off over there. So fire, two frags by him. And on the save, MYM still has a chance, but he's forced down to just 6 health. DSN just going to town there with that AK-47. Not really giving PRB much of a chance to do anything here, Trev.
Yeah, so all that action happening right there in that lower ramp area. We call that the kitty ramp because there's a picture of a kitty cat or a cat on the wall there, and it rotates with a symbol of the Cyber Amateur League Cal's logo. So again, there it is right there on cue. My boys are right on top of it. So there's the Amateur League. Hope we get the quick rotation here to the picture of the cat. I'd love to see it again. There it is.
There it is. You can see there's the angry kitty cat. There right
so they
there.
They call it the angry kitty ramp, and they're moving up angry kitty right now. And yeah. Let's see.
This is going to be the first full gun round for both teams. Fnatic, of course, winning the last three. MYM finally able to buy some Colts. Juvie's going to start things off over there. Looks like that was in the middle. Archie goes down, so the middle guy was over there with the bomb, DSN. They're trying to do a split of bombsite number one, the A bombsite. And you can see MYM has that middle locked down. They love to play three guys over there.
Yeah, so pushing into this, it's a 3-on-3, as it looks like Element is pushed into the bombsite area here. He is in the actual plant spot, and they're trying to boost on top of him. Let's see if they get him here. He's going to boost up. Can they get a shot? Element is waiting for it.
There he is on the ground. Element, you know, big mistake here by Fnatic, though. Big mistake. They didn't get the bomb planted. It was over there trapped on that ramp up there. DSN never able to get back into the site because of the coverage from the middle.
But if they get that boost and they get over there and they do take out Element, there's an opportunity for them to win that round. But Element was waiting for it. He was looking up for that boost and he saw it coming. So great little play right there. We finally see some action from him, Element that is, and we're going to need him to start playing better for MYM if we're going to expect a close match here.
And MYM really needs to pick up rounds on this defensive side. I mean, Fnatic is just so good on both sides of the map. They have to do something here, and this is really, it's going to be so hard to do it for Fnatic.
How many rounds would you want if you were on defensive side?
If I was on the defensive side, I'd easily want 8 to 10, maybe even as many as 11 on this. I mean, that's going to be hard to get against a team like Fnatic, but 8 to 10 is where I'm going to put what you need to be heading into the second half on the offensive side with a nice good chance of winning the match. So you can see MYM has started it off again. Fnatic already down to just 3 guys, and right now the bomb in the hands of Force. He's in the sewers here. It's now a 4-on-3. Juvie has a nice frag there in the middle, make it a 4-on-2. This is looking pretty good so far for MYM.
Yeah, right now in this situation, he's making a ton of noise, and they know he's down there. Normally what happens is you go into that sewer area, it's right below this entire map, you can't really see it, and you're getting a good shot of it right here. This sewer area, you can hear them from up above, so if you're up above, you can actually hear him down below. So all that noise he makes, it makes it easy to hear him and know he's there. But again, I don't think they actually paid attention. They didn't hear him. Yeah, so I thought he was making too much noise, but they didn't actually hear
him.
Well,
what happened there was he shot the grate out, and you can, of course, hear that.
Oh,
the
yeah.
guys stacked right above him, turned around, and were able to get the frag. It's hard. You don't really have any aim when you're stuck on a ladder like that. So if a player's climbing up a ladder, you can't really successfully aim at a guy because the recoil goes all over the place. Right now, score 3-2, the offensive side with the advantage.
Yeah, so getting a shot there of Element and moving in as we also see the other tandem, Forest. So Element and Forest back to back, watching as they rush up Angry Kitty here. Again, Fnatic on a save.
Yeah, a little bit of baiting there by Tentpole. The save round. Oh, nice aim there by Cyan. Gets the guy jumping through the air. No armor for those guys on the save though. Makes it nice and easy. They tie it 3-3 right now. So now we should see another buy for Fnatic. They just saved that last one. They should have AKs this round.
Yeah, and then again, like we said, Fnatic saving up, trying to win this round. So an important round. Fnatic putting a lot on this one. And MYM is going to need to answer back and start building up a lead here. This is their map. They need to step up and win this map. Fnatic has played extremely well. Their backs are against the wall as well. Fnatic wins another map. This entire tournament is over.
Yeah, so take a look at DSN. He has that AWP. He's on that ramp with a teammate. Looks like that's Forrest. Those guys love to play together, Forrest and DSN. Constantly, we saw them in the lower bomb side of train before.
Very good teamwork, but again, Forrest getting blinded. He was up in the corner of that wall, and he got stopped. Nice counterattack here by MYM. They really, that's something you have to do on this map.
Yeah, you have to, if you're the CTs, you need to push back. Oh, a nice shot by DSN. Man, he really came around, pulled the scope off, and shot the guy nice and quick. Has changed the momentum of this round. It's now a 3-on-2. The odds were much worse. It was a 5-on-2 before that. But take a look at DSN. He's down to just 18 health here. Going to be hard to get in. If I were him, I'd save that big AWP.
That's probably what I would do as well. Element waiting. The bomb is down in control of MYM. They've surrounded it. They're holding onto it. Karn and DSN maybe trying to work their way in. They're going to need to do a lot of work here. I would wait and hope that MYM makes a mistake. Karn able to pick off Element, though, so he's starting to make some plays here. But Real and Juvenile both know, and time is ticking right there below Fnatic's name.
10 seconds left in the round, and they get him.
What a big mistake. Stupid play by Juvenile. I'm sorry, but you do not peek in that situation. There's only 4 seconds left. Where are you going? You know they're pushed up into that middle area. Why? What is the reasoning there? What is he thinking?
Well, what it is poor clock management right there. He wasn't watching the timer, peeks out. Gets his face blown in half by a nice AWPing from DSN.
So, again, a couple of mistakes here leading to it, and MYM, they haven't been blown out. It's not like they're getting blown out of this game. They just simply have not been making enough plays, and they're making simple mistakes that are allowing Fnatic to take control of this game. 4-3 score for Fnatic.
Yeah, here we go. Another round here for these guys. Forrest just going to work with Archie. A nice attack here into the site for these guys. They're going to get a plant. And Element's going to go down, I believe. There, that will be the round again. 5-3 the score on the offense has the advantage here. Fnatic, they're such an offensive powerhouse. You can see their play in getting into these bomb sites has really, knocked MYM off their momentum here.
Again, we talked about how important that Angry Kitty ramp is. We see a lot of action down there. So what happens is the defensive team needs to sense when an attack's coming, counter flash, and rush in there, the bottom of the screen there. They have to counterattack that area. They can't sit back and be passive, because if you allow Fnatic to creep their way up, they can use AWPs, they can use different weapons to allow themselves to sneak in there, and they can do a ton of damage. So it's very, very hard to hold that ramp if you don't work your way and counterattack it. Right now, MYM playing very passively, and I think that's been one of the reasons they've been so unsuccessful.
And you saw Element there had the FAMAS, which indicates some money troubles for MYM. You know, when you lose rounds like that consecutively and, you know, get one, lose one, get another one, lose one, that really hurts the money situation for the counter-terrorist side. The weapons are so expensive, you don't get that bonus.
Again, we're following DSN right here, and he's got Forrest next to him with the bomb in hand. Forrest can take out one.
Oh.
DSN going to get another right there, 15 life, as the two partner tandem work their way up Angry Kitty yet again and get a plant here for their team. Those two have absolutely been holding it down.
Three-on-one situation. Real is the last member alive. He was the last member alive before Archie barged up the middle with that AK-47 and guns him down. Really, no chance for MYM. They're continuously put into man-down situations here with the bomb planted. That's not where you want to be if you're on the defensive side.
Where's the energy we saw yesterday? Where is it? Where is the energy we saw from all of these teams yesterday? Fnatic, they don't need it. They're being absolutely precision, but where is the energy for MYM? Where is the energy from Element? They don't even look like they're losing right now. They need to get into this game. They need to start pumping up their team. They need to start building some momentum here. They're not doing anything. Where is it?
Yeah,
we
I
saw
don't know.
So much excitement yesterday. The actual tournament area was ablaze with people yelling and screaming. Today, we haven't seen anything out of these teams. Did somebody forget their coffee this morning?
I don't know, but, you know, that's what kind of Megan was talking about earlier. People falling asleep. Forrest, it looks like MYM going to be on the save here. Coming around, you can see Forrest just waiting for them to peek. Oh, what a Glock shot to the face. Man, that hurts. That hurt my head again. That's the second
and
nice
that
shot.
Was in the air, too. You're not as accurate in the air, so jumping across. And we're going to go right to the action here. As, again, Forrest in the pink hat here. Playing extremely well for his team. MYM playing amazing.
Look at Karn. He's 12-6 for his team, so he has the top score right now in the map. Karn playing very well for Fnatic. Forrest here on the main screen. You can see him in, you know, the crosshairs there, looking to get a frag, but MYM over in the middle here. Nice shot by Forrest making his way up the middle. It looks like the bomb is dropped over on the ramp. You can see it on Forrest's screen right there. Archie is going to return fire and get a couple of frags. Right now we're looking at a 3-on-3 even situation. Real taking Archie out over in the middle. Got him as he was trying to sneak back into storage area 1. A nice grenade by PRB is going to give MYM the big time advantage on this map.
Again, like we talked about, they got to counterattack that. You got to keep them
Ooh.
Down. See, they're not even letting them up. MYM is that round finally showing some life there on that side. DSN and Forrest before that have been absolutely crushing that ramp, that Angry Kitty ramp, and finally we see MYM take control of it. You've got to play over there. You've got to control that ramp, and if you don't, you can get absolutely flanked and taken apart in this map.
Now, how important are the smokes and the grenades and flashes on this map for an offensive site? I mean, you need to get into the site. If you flash the guys in there, and how important are counter nades?
Yeah, when one team throws a flash, the other team has to slow down that rush or you're going to be absolutely crushed. This is an example right here where they did not counter flash and they got right in. Fnatic rushed right in. They got the flashes off. Fnatic, we never saw a single flash there from MYM. Perfect opportunity to show that, and Fnatic just rolled them.
I think maybe there was only one frag there for MYM. I think PRB was the only one who got a frag, and that was a gun round. I mean, that's just poor play. Poor play for those guys. They need to hold that. They need to lock that site down. They need to do whatever it takes. I don't care if it's spam before the guys rush up, grenades, anything right now to get back into this.
I hate to throw Element under the bus again, but he's 2-9. So if you combine his first second half map of the first one and this, he's 4-16 right now.
Yeah, that's not. They need Element to step up. You saw him on the cam there. Just no emotion from that guy. Not at all. So take a look. 8-4 is the score. The timer is ticking. A minute 15 left in the round. We're looking at a 2-on-2 situation here. And make that a 2-on-1 as Archie inside of storage area 1 comes around and gets the guy. Real, the last member alive here for MYM. Tentpole going to go grab the bomb, which was still sitting inside the terrorist spawn, the offensive spawn. You can see on the overhead here, they're going to move through storage area 1, and Real's going to make the smart choice and head into bomb site number 1, but he has just a USP on the save. That's going to be very difficult to take out two guys who have armor and weapons.
Yeah, watching here, Real pushing up, trying to take advantage of it, but they heard him running there, and they heard him come up, and there they took him out to win that round, make it 9-4 right now, as Fnatic is absolutely cruising. They know it. They can feel it. That 30 grand is starting to feel good in the back of their wallet.
Yeah, you know, and right now, 9-6 is what the score needs to be for MYM if they're going to have a chance of coming back right now. MYM needs to win out the last two rounds. And it looks like they will have guns here. I'm taking a look at some of the players. They're going to spread out and put three guys, make that four between the middle and bomb site number one. Archie's going to make his way up, running into some trouble there. And MIM's going to do a nice job of the grenades and the smoke there. Totally blind for that guy as he came up the ramp. But DSN took advantage of the stack on the other side by MIM and is going to get a nice easy plant inside the other site. Fnatic setting up here for the counterattack.
Yeah, look at Forrest keeping track of where his teammate is so that he can make sure he protects him. That was smart little play. Nobody came, but that's the little type of thing that Forrest does. A great player, great teammate.
Oh, man, look at that quick snap to the head. They're just going around and rolling kids, man.
They are, but a two-on-one right here. DSN all by himself. Both guys up in the site right now.
DSN, he's going to get the first one. Oh, look at that. The guy was on the bomb. He had the defuse. Remember, the bomb is ticking. So the guy tried to get on it. His teammate didn't do a good job. Guessed that he was behind the door. They were too far away when the initial bomb was planted, so they didn't know where he was hiding, and they didn't see him. So that enabled them to enabled DSN to get the drop on both guys. And when you're stuck on that bomb defusing, it's so hard to get up because it takes a second for the gun to come back up before you can shoot.
10-4 score right now as we get to this last round of the second half, or the first half, excuse me, before we go to the second half. Again, I think MYM must win this round. It's already too big of a deficit, in my opinion. 10-4 is a lot of rounds that they have to make up in the second half. Down by 6, they can't have this be 7. They've got to make this round to keep it at 5 rounds to get back to.
Yeah, 10-4 is... If you're Fnatic right now, though, you're sitting so pretty. You're going to only... I mean... You win this round, and you get the pistol in the next half, and it's almost a lock. This match is in the bag for you. That 30 grand first place prize is looking pretty good for Fnatic right now. You can see them making their entrance up to Kitty here. That's Karn. Nice flash work there by those guys. Archie going to get in. But
he's got to go for this right now, but he's on a 3-on-1, so it's going to be very difficult to do so. It looks like another round for Fnatic as they continue to absolutely roll MYM. It just doesn't even feel like MYM woke up this morning, seriously.
Yeah, they're definitely not looking good at all. And there's Archie down long on the Angry Kitty. Picks him off, an 11-4 first half score for Fnatic. And I got to say, they are doing a great job of beating up on the other team's map. Like we said, that was going to be a key point here. They needed to win the map that they didn't pick. So, impressive play by Fnatic. I think, you know, they don't even want to take a break. They're ready to go. It's just at this point, let's get it over with.
Yeah, if I was in the situation of Fnatic, I would be readying up. I would be doing everything I possibly could to get this match going again. Do not give any momentum to MYM. Don't give them an opportunity to get back into this. Don't even let them think they have a chance, because right now they don't. You can just see it. They don't think they have a chance.
Yeah, no momentum here whatsoever. No emotion. We spoke to that before. Fnatic is just, and really Fnatic is a group of guys. I was watching them play earlier. They just take it easy. We are going to go live here, but they take it so easy when they're playing. They're calm. They don't jump up and down like Pentagram does all the time. And teams like Jax, Money Crew, those guys get so emotional, but Fnatic doesn't seem to be that. They're just nice, easy. They kind of remind me of Method. That's the way he plays as well.
Yeah, and that professional, very, you know, almost assured mentality has worked for them so far in this tournament. It doesn't work for other teams, though. I think teams like you said, Jax, Money Crew, they have to play well. JMC has to have that huge momentum burst. A lot of players yelling and screaming to play really well. So it's just different styles, and it's working here for Fnatic.
Right now, Fnatic has a nice, interesting... They had a nice, interesting three-man stack on the Kitty. They've since fallen back. Force is there pushing, and it looks like Fnatic's going to push on the defensive side here. They get a ton of frags, man. Look at this. Fnatic playing the defensive side like it's offense. They trap the guys in storage area number one, and they clean them all up right there. Nice pistol round win. This is not looking good whatsoever for the boys from MYM. Not at all.
Yep, so right now watching as they set up here for the next round, it should be a save here. MYM didn't even get close to the bomb site. They didn't even get close to planning it, so there's no way they have any money at all to get ready for this round.
Yeah, Element, just the look on his face. He's frustrated. I think he knows this one is over right now, 12-4.
I mean, at this point, I think he's not even taking anything seriously, so I don't know. I question it. We talked about it in the roundtable. I really thought they needed Oops on this team. He's such a great player. Look at Archie taking him down.
Man, that was a nice round by both those guys. Archie and Tentpole both had double frags there on the save. 2-0 the score. And, Fnatic continuing to march closer to the first place prize. All they need to do is get a couple more rounds, and That's it. They'll have a 2-0 sweep in the map here in the best of three during this match. 30 grand could be theirs in just a couple minutes, Trev.
Yeah, they continue to play this way, that's for sure. It's going to take an epic comeback here from MYM. There's no sense that that's even possible at this point. And MYM still, with Deagles, doesn't have enough money to buy here in this round, so they're going to have to save yet another one here, and that's going to make it probably 14-4.
Yeah, you can see Archie going to work. Well, here we go. Deegs up the Angry Kitty. PRB picks up two big ones. DSN on the rotation with his teammate. Forrest in the middle goes down. There's Element, but he didn't have time. He was stuck reloading that Deagle. Remember, there's only 7 bullets in that clip. You can see DSN going to work in the middle, picks up a couple more frags, and now there's just one member left alive for MYM. It's a 2-on-1. PRB, he does have the bomb, but here comes DSN. You can see him. He's coming from behind, and Fnatic Karn, you see, he has to plant the bomb to the left of the crosshairs there, and DSN gets him. The guy was on the other side and didn't ever have a chance to make it to the bomb plant spot. Right now, it's a 14-4 score, and I think this one, I'm going to go out here and say it's as good as done, Trev.
It is. It's basically winding down. We've had a great CPL. Please don't take anything conclusions from this. We had an amazing 3D complexity match. We had an amazing couple of other matches in this tournament, and I had a blast casting. This has been one of the best CPLs so far in record, but at the same time, we're not getting that kind of a match here in the final, and it's disappointing to see.
But you know what, though, with that group of death as we've been referring it to, it's so hard to live up to that kind of a match. I mean, matches in a row, even. We had 3 or 4 good ones just in that one group. You can see MYM coming back here. They had the bye, and you can see Fnatic returning fire. So right now we got 2-on-2, and Zion's going to come up big. Karn's still alive. A CT win. It's now 15-4, tie point. MYM needs to win out, and right now they had to buy whatever they could. This is not a good situation. I think this one is over right here after this round.
Yeah, buying for each other right now. I think a few M4s on the ground in the Fnatic base as they've swapped weapons. So those guys getting ready, fully loaded here. MYM, though, buying AKs, getting ready to try to take this round out. But again, this is going to be interesting.
Yeah, Karn here, you can see the little bit of pre-fire trying to hit anybody who may be in storage area too. We haven't seen MYM go to that side of the map, like, barely at all. They've worked totally the bomb site A side, and I think Fnatic has responded by planting 3 to 4 guys over there. DSN is going to push through on the halls, according to the overhead. Now MYM making their way up the kitty ramp. Karn is over there, though. Grenades flying, you can see on 4 screen. DSN is there. 10th pro. Good games being exchanged by Element as Fnatic rolls through MYM here. And that is going to be it. Fnatic, your new CPL 2006 winner champions in a 2-0 sweep of Meet Your Makers. And that's going to be it. They're going to go home with 30 grand, Trevor.
Players hugging each other. Hey, I'd hug Forrest too. He was absolutely dominant through this match. He just crushed people right and left. He was just unbelievable. Winning 2 straight maps here. They won not only their map, they won the other team's map. They played extremely well. It looked like MYM never even woke up to play this match.
So am I still waiting for this world to stop hating? Can't find a good reason, can't find hope to believe in.